This conference will now be recorded.
Good morning, students. Last class, I started this Rankine's earth pressure theory. We know that in the earth retaining structures, the retaining walls are subjected to different types of horizontal earth pressures from the backfill soil. Already we discussed the at rest horizontal earth pressure acting on the retaining walls. Then after that, the another horizontal earth pressure acting on the retaining walls is active earth pressure. When the retaining wall is moving away from the backfill applies the active horizontal earth pressure on the retaining wall. So the second type of earth pressure, horizontal earth pressure acting on the retaining wall, is the active horizontal earth pressure. By using this Rankine's earth pressure theory, by using the Rankine's earth pressure theory, we can determine the active horizontal earth pressure acting on the retaining walls. So last class I started this Rankine's active earth pressure theory, important concept in unit 3. It is asked in the semester examinations number of times. So please follow this Rankine's earth pressure theory carefully, important. Before going to discuss this Rankine's earth pressure theory, I would like to discuss the important concept in foundation engineering, that is the failure envelope in soils. The concept of failure envelope in soils. What is that concept of failure envelope in soils? We know that the shear strength of soil according to Coulomb's equation is given by S is equal to, this is that Coulomb's equation. Actually, it is called Coulomb's Morse equation. That equation is called Coulomb-Morse equation. The shear strength of soil, S is equal to C plus sigma tan phi. In that equation, S is the shear strength of soil. We can also indicate that as tau. C is the cohesion in the soil. Between the soil particles, there is an attraction force that is called cohesion in the soil. Sigma is the normal stress acting on the soil. Phi is the angle of shearing resistance of the soil. This is the Coulomb-Morse equation to find out the shear strength of the soil or the shear resistance of the soil. You know that we have basically two types of soils, cohesionless soil and cohesive soil. If the cohesion in soil is zero, if there is no attraction between the soil particles like sand, we call that soil as a cohesionless soil. In the cohesionless soil, this cohesion C becomes zero. There is no attraction between the soil particles. So in the cohesionless soil, the Mohr Coulomb's equation, the shear strength of soil is given by S is equal to, or tau is equal to, sigma tan phi. So that is the shear strength or the shear resistance of soil when the cohesion C is zero. That is, the soil is a cohesionless soil. So in the cohesionless soil, the shear strength of the soil according to Coulomb-Mohr equation is given by S is equal to sigma tan phi, or tau is equal to sigma tan phi. We can prepare a graph by using this equation. This is called the Coulomb-Mohr's equation for the shear strength of cohesionless soil. Tau is equal to sigma tan phi. By using this equation, we can prepare the graph. In that graph, take this normal stress on x-axis, take the shear stress on y axis, or the shear strength on y axis. So take the shear strength on y axis, the normal stress sigma on x axis. This equation becomes as y is equal to m, that is tan phi, m into x. This equation is y is equal to mx form. So we can prepare a graph by using this equation. In that graph, take normal stress sigma on x axis, the shear stress or the shear strength tau on y axis. From that equation, you will get this graph like a straight line. So in this graph, the normal stress acting on the soil is taken on x axis. The shear stress or the shear strength of soil is taken on y axis. Then the graph tau is equal to sigma tan phi is a straight line passing through horizon. That straight line is called the failure envelope of the cohesionless soil. Very, very important in cohesionless soil. The equation of failure envelope of the cohesionless soil is S is equal to or tau is equal to sigma tan phi. In terms of effective stresses, tan phi dash. This straight line failure envelope is making an angle phi dash with the horizontal or with the normal stress axis sigma. So in the cohesionless soil, the failure envelope is a important concept. Why it is important? If the stress in the cohesionless soil is below the failure envelope, if the normal stress and the shear stress in the cohesionless soil is below the failure envelope, the soil is stable. If the normal stress and shear stress in the cohesionless soil lies on the failure envelope, the soil is under failure condition. So in the cohesionless soil, to understand, to estimate, to determine the stability of the cohesionless soil, we are using this failure envelope for the cohesionless soil. So please follow this failure envelope in the cohesionless soil carefully. This is Coulomb-Mohr's equation. If the stress in the cohesionless soil, normal stress and also shear stress, is below this failure envelope, the soil is stable. If the stress in the cohesionless soil is on that failure envelope, the cohesionless soil is under failure condition. So by using this failure envelope of the cohesionless soil, we can understand whether that cohesionless soil is in the stable condition or in the failure condition. So please remember, this straight line passing through horizon making an angle phi dash with the x axis or normal stress axis. The equation of that straight line is S is equal to tau is equal to sigma tan phi dash. That straight line is called the failure envelope of the cohesionless soil. By using this failure envelope introduction, we are going to discuss the Coulomb, the Rankine's earth pressure theory. So in the year 1857, Rankine proposed the earth pressure theory. Rankine proposed the earth pressure theory to find out the magnitude of active earth pressure and also passive earth pressure acting on the retaining walls. In the year 1857, Rankine proposed the earth pressure theory. In that Rankine earth pressure theory, Rankine assumed the backfill is a cohesionless soil. So in the earth pressure theory, first Rankine assumed the backfill. You know this meaning of backfill. Backfill means the soil supported by retaining wall is called backfill. So in the earth pressure theory, Rankine assumed that the backfill is a cohesionless soil and the backfill is a dry backfill. So the backfill in the earth pressure theory, Rankine earth pressure theory, is a dry soil and that backfill is a cohesionless soil. By using these assumptions, what are the assumptions? The backfill is dry and the backfill is a cohesionless soil. Rankine in the year 1857 developed the earth pressure theory to find out the active earth pressure and also the passive earth pressure acting on the retaining walls. Then the Rankine's earth pressure theory was modified by Russell in the year 1910 and also the person Bell in the year 1915, so that the Rankine earth pressure theory is also applicable to cohesive soils like clay soils. At the beginning, in the year 1857, Rankine developed the earth pressure theory for the oceanless soil, but the Russell and the Bell, these two persons, they modify this Rankine's earth pressure theory so that the Rankine's earth pressure theory is also applicable to cohesive soils. So this is introduction about the Rankine's earth pressure theory. By using this Rankine's earth pressure theory, we can find out the magnitudes of passive earth pressure and also active earth pressure acting on the retaining wall. Remember, in the Rankine's earth pressure theory, the backfill is assumed as a oceanless soil. Coming to this Rankine's earth pressure theory, in the year 1857, Rankine proposed the earth pressure theory to find out the magnitudes of active earth pressure and passive earth pressure acting on the retaining walls. In that earth pressure theory, Rankine earth pressure theory, he made some assumptions. We have some assumptions in the Rankine's earth pressure theory. So the Rankine's earth pressure theory is having some assumptions. What are those assumptions in the Rankine's earth pressure theory? First assumption, the soil is homogeneous and semi-infinite. Soil means backfill behind the retaining wall. The soil is homogeneous and semi-infinite, first assumption. Second assumption, the soil is dry condition, that is moisture, partially saturated, not fully dry. The soil is dry condition and it is oceanless soil, the backfill. So this is the next assumption. The backfill is in dry condition and the backfill is a oceanless soil. Third assumption, the ground surface is plain, that is the top of the backfill. The top of the backfill is plain. That top of the backfill is either horizontal or inclined in both conditions. The top of the backfill is plain, not curved or irregular. The top of the backfill is plain, that is ground surface. And that top of the backfill may be either horizontal or inclined. Then the fourth assumption, the backside of the retaining wall. The backside of the retaining wall in contact with the backfill soil. So the backside of the retaining wall in contact with the backfill soil is smooth and that is vertical. So the fourth assumption, the retaining wall backside in contact with the backfill soil, the backside of the retaining wall is smooth and it is vertical. Fifth assumption, the soil element in the backfill. Soil element in the backfill is in plastic equilibrium condition. That is the fifth assumption. The soil element in the backfill, either in the active condition or in the passive condition, the soil element in the backfill is in the equilibrium condition, is in the plastic equilibrium condition. Plastic equilibrium condition indicates the soil element is on failure situation, at the edge of failure, that is called wedge of failure. So in the active condition and also in the passive condition, the soil element in the backfill is in plastic equilibrium condition and it is about to failure, that is called wedge of failure. Rankine proposed the earth pressure theory to find out the expressions for active earth pressure and also passive earth pressure. In the Rankine's earth pressure theory, we have the equations to determine the active horizontal earth pressure acting on the retaining wall, and also the passive horizontal earth pressure acting on the retaining wall. Verge of failure means about to failure. It reaches the failure condition. It is not in the elastic equilibrium condition. It is just and on the edge of failure. VRGE, verge of failure or edge of failure, both are same. Verge or edge, both indicates the same meaning. About to failure, reaches the failure. So that is called the verge of failure of the side element. In the Rankine's earth pressure theory, the Rankine's earth pressure theory, the expressions are there for the active horizontal earth pressure and also the passive horizontal earth pressure acting on the retaining walls. First, we are going to discuss the Rankine's earth pressure theory for the active horizontal earth pressure. Then we will discuss the Rankine's earth pressure theory for the passive horizontal earth pressure on the retaining wall. So please everyone, go through these assumptions made in the Rankine's earth pressure theory. These assumptions are applicable both for the active earth pressure and also for the passive earth pressure. So in the short answers questions, the question may come, explain the assumptions in Rankine's earth pressure theory. So please everyone, go through those five assumptions on the screen in your cell phones. Understand those assumptions in the Rankine's earth pressure theory. So these five are the assumptions made in the Rankine's earth pressure theory. Please look at that last point in that slide. The Rankine's earth pressure theory is applicable to prepare the equations for the active horizontal earth pressure and also the passive horizontal earth pressure. First, I am going to explain you what is this active horizontal earth pressure according to this Rankine's earth pressure theory. So first I am going to discuss with you the Rankine's earth pressure theory for the active earth pressure. So check this slide title, the Rankine's active earth pressure theory. Similarly, we have the Rankine's passive earth pressure theory also. So first we are going to discuss how to calculate the active earth pressure, active horizontal earth pressure acting on the retaining wall as per this Rankine's theory. So I am going to explain you the Rankine's active earth pressure theory. In this Rankine's active earth pressure theory, first we consider the retaining wall supporting the backfill. Please watch this picture on the cell phone screens. We consider the retaining wall supporting the backfill. In this Rankine's active earth pressure theory, first we assume the retaining wall is in rest condition. So please follow this carefully. In the Rankine's active earth pressure theory, first we assume the retaining wall is in rest condition. So that backfill is also in rest condition. The backfill is also in rest condition. There is no elongation in the backfill. There is no compression in the backfill. Because the retaining wall is in rest condition, the backfill is also in rest condition. Rest condition means elastic equilibrium condition, no failure. Because the backfill is neither subjected to stretching nor subjected to compression in the rest condition, there is no failure in the backfill. So the backfill is in elastic equilibrium condition. So in the Rankine's active earth pressure theory, we consider the retaining wall supporting the backfill soil. First, we assume the retaining wall is in rest condition. So the backfill is also in rest condition. In the rest condition, the backfill is in elastic equilibrium condition. We know that the Rankine's earth pressure theory considered the backfill is a cohesionless soil. We know in the assumptions also we discuss in the Rankine's earth pressure theory, we assume the backfill is a cohesionless soil. Take gamma is the bulk unit weight of this backfill cohesionless soil in the partially saturated condition. It is not totally dry. It is in the moist condition, partially saturated. Take gamma is the bulk unit weight of this cohesionless backfill soil. Now consider the soil element in the backfill. Consider the soil element. What is the condition of the backfill? Rest condition. At that rest condition, consider the soil element in the backfill. Let this soil element is at a depth z from the top of the backfill. At a depth z from the top of the backfill. Then this soil element in the backfill subjected to the vertical normal stress sigma v and also the horizontal normal stress sigma h. Two normal stresses are acting on this soil element in the backfill. We consider the soil element in the backfill at a depth z from the top of the backfill. The backfill is under rest condition. In that rest condition, this soil element subjected to two normal stresses. One is the vertical normal stress sigma v. Next one is the horizontal normal stress sigma h. Neglect the normal stress in the z-axis direction. Neglect the normal stress in the z-axis direction. Then this soil element subjected to only normal stresses sigma v and sigma h. No shear stress acting on this soil element. No shear stress acting on the soil element. We know that in no shear stress condition, when the element is in no shear stress condition, these two normal stresses, sigma v, sigma h, are called principal stresses. Since this soil element is in no shear stress condition, there is no shear stress acting on the soil element on any plane. Since the soil element is in no shear stress condition, sigma v, sigma h are called the principal stresses. Sigma v is called the principal vertical stress. Sigma h is called the principal horizontal stress. So, in the Rankine's active earth pressure theory, we consider the retaining wall supporting the backfill. First, we assume the retaining wall is in rest condition. So, the backfill is also in the rest condition. That is elastic equilibrium condition. No failure in the backfill in the rest condition. In Rankine's theory, we assume the backfill as a cohesionless backfill. In the rest condition, at a depth z from the top of the backfill, consider the soil element. The soil element in the rest condition subjected to two normal stresses, vertical normal stress sigma v, horizontal normal stress sigma h. Since no shear stress acting on this soil element, these two normal stresses are called the principal normal stresses. We know that in the rest condition, previous classes we discussed, in the rest condition, sigma h, horizontal stress, sigma h is equal to k naught into sigma v. In the at rest condition, the horizontal stress sigma h is equal to k naught into sigma v. So this soil element subjected to two principal stresses, sigma v and sigma h. Check that element, please. So everyone, please focus on this element in the backfill. The element in the backfill subjected to two normal stresses, sigma v and sigma h. The element is in rest condition. since the element is in rest condition, the horizontal stress sigma h is equal to k naught into sigma v. So here in the Rankine's active earth pressure theory, first we consider the backfill is in rest condition. In that rest condition, the soil element in the backfill subjected to two principal stresses, sigma v and sigma h. In the rest condition, sigma v greater than sigma h. In the rest condition, sigma v greater than sigma h. Sigma v is called major principal stress. Sigma h is called minor principal stress. Remember, these two stresses are the normal stresses. Sigma v normal to horizontal plane, sigma h normal to vertical plane. So sigma v, sigma h are called the normal stresses, principal stresses on the soil element A. Now coming to the Mohr's stress circle. Since this soil element subjected to two normal stresses, sigma v, sigma h, by using these two normal stresses, sigma v, sigma h, we can prepare the Mohr's stress circle for this soil element. Mohr's stress circle. The Mohr's stress circle is drawn by taking the normal stress on x-axis, by taking the shear stress on y-axis. In the Mohr's stress circle, the Mohr's stress circle for the elastic body is drawn by considering the normal stress on the elastic body on x-axis sigma, by considering the shear stress on the elastic body on y-axis tau. So in the Mohr's stress circle, the normal stress on the elastic body taken on the x-axis, the shear stress on the elastic body taken on the y-axis. We can prepare that Mohr's stress circle by using this normal stress and shear stress. But here, the soil element subjected to only normal stresses, no shear stress. By using these two normal stresses, sigma v, sigma h, we can prepare the Mohr's stress circle for this soil element in the rest condition. That is important. Sigma v, sigma h in this diagram is for the rest condition of this soil element. So prepare the Mohr's stress circle for this soil element in the rest condition by using the two normal stresses, sigma v and sigma h. So on the x-axis, that is a normal stress axis, first sigma h is taken as OA. So from this origin up to this point A, OA indicates the horizontal normal stress acting on the element. This length OA is equal to sigma h, but sigma h is equal to k naught into sigma v in the rest condition. So in this Mohr's stress circle, this length OA is equal to k naught into sigma v. Then the other normal stress is sigma v. Take this sigma v, the next normal stress also on the x-axis, normal stress axis. The length OB in this diagram, length OB indicates that normal stress on the soil element. So we consider these two normal stresses, sigma v, sigma h, acting on this soil element on the x-axis, normal stress axis, in this Mohr's stress circle. So OA indicates the sigma h, OB indicates the sigma v. Then by using point A, point B, this is sigma h, point A, point B is sigma v. By using this AB as a diameter, by using this AB as a diameter, draw the Mohr's stress circle in this diagram. Draw the Mohr's stress circle. The Mohr's stress circle with the diameter AB that is indicated as the first Mohr's stress circle. This is the Mohr's stress circle for this soil element in the rest condition. So we started Rankine's active earth pressure theory. In the Rankine's active earth pressure theory, first we consider the backfill is in rest condition. So the soil element is also in the rest condition. In the rest condition, the soil element is subjected to two normal stresses, sigma V, sigma H. Since it is in the rest condition, sigma H is equal to K naught into sigma V. Take these two normal stresses, sigma V, sigma H, on the normal stress axis, that is called sigma axis, normal stress axis, also x axis. Take the stresses sigma V, sigma H on the normal stress axis. In the rest condition, sigma V more than sigma H. So in this diagram, OA indicates sigma H, that is K naught into sigma V. OB indicates sigma V, vertical stress. Then by taking this diameter AB, by taking this AB as diameter, draw the Mohr's stress circle in the diagram. That is the first circle. This is the Mohr's stress circle when the soil element is in rest condition. In this diagram, we also indicates the failure envelope for the oceanless soil. Just in the today's class, I explained according to Coulomb-Mohr equation for the oceanless soil, S is equal to tau is equal to sigma tan phi. That is this straight line. This straight line is the failure envelope. S is equal to sigma tan phi. So this failure envelope is also taken in the diagram. Check this first Mohr stress circle in the rest condition. The first Mohr stress circle, this stress circle indicates the stresses in the backfill at rest condition. This stress circle, Mohr's stress circle, please focus on the AB, Mohr's stress circle, first stress circle. The first stress circle, AB, indicates the stresses in the backfill in at rest condition. Since this stress circle, AB, is below the failure envelope, since this stress circle is below the failure envelope, the backfill in this rest condition, please observe this, the first Mohr stress circle is for the rest condition of the backfill. Since this first stress circle is below the failure envelope, it indicates in the rest condition, the backfill is not subjected to failure, because this stress circle, first stress circle for the rest condition is below the failure envelope. So the stresses in the backfill in at rest condition is below the failure envelope stresses. So that backfill in the rest condition is not subjected to failure. That is elastic equilibrium condition. So in the Rankine's active earth pressure theory, first we consider the backfill is in rest condition. We prepare the Mohr's stress circle for that rest condition of the backfill, that is this Mohr's stress circle AB. Since this stress circle in the rest condition is below the failure envelope, the backfill in the rest condition is not subjected to failure. It is in elastic equilibrium condition. That is, the Mohr's stress circle AB for the rest condition of the backfill. OA indicates sigma H. OB indicates sigma V. Now coming to the active condition of the retaining wall. So far we discussed the rest condition of the retaining wall. Coming to the active condition of the retaining wall. When the retaining wall is in active condition, we discussed in the previous classes, in the active condition, the retaining wall is moving away from the backfill. That is active condition of retaining wall. So in the active condition, the retaining wall starts moving away from the backfill. When the retaining wall starts moving away from the backfill, then in this soil element, please observe this carefully. So far I explained the rest condition. Now I am explaining the active condition. In the active condition, the retaining wall is moving away from the backfill. When this retaining wall is moving away from the backfill subjected to horizontal stretching. That is one type of relaxation. Since this retaining wall is moving away from the backfill subjected to horizontal stretching. Because of that horizontal stretching on this side element, the vertical stress remains constant in the active condition. Vertical stress remains constant, but the horizontal stress sigma h starts decreasing. This sigma h starts decreasing in the active condition because the retaining wall is moving away from the backfill. So the backfill is subjected to horizontal stretching. Because of that horizontal stretching on this element, sigma v remains constant, but sigma h horizontal stress gradually decreases. Now coming to the Mohr's stress circle, what is happen to the Mohr's stress circle if sigma v constant, sigma h gradually decreases? Check that Mohr's stress circle in this diagram. So far I explained the first Mohr's stress circle for the rest condition, but in the active condition, in the active condition on this soil element, sigma v is constant. In this diagram, what is that sigma v? OB is sigma v. From origin up to this point B is the sigma v stress. In the active condition, sigma v is constant. Since sigma v is constant, the point B remains same in the diagram. No change in this point B because in the active condition, vertical stress remains constant. But in the active condition, sigma h gradually decreasing. When sigma h gradually decreasing, the point A in this diagram indicates the sigma h in the rest condition. So please check this diagram. In the diagram, point A indicates sigma h in the rest condition. Point B indicates sigma v in the rest condition. In the active condition, sigma v constant. Sigma v, since constant, point B is also constant in the diagram. No change in the point B. But in the active condition, sigma h gradually decreases. Since sigma h in the active condition decreases, the point A, that is sigma h point. Point A indicates the sigma h. If sigma h is decreasing, point A is moving towards the horizon because length OA indicates the sigma h stress. The length OA in the diagram indicates the sigma h stress. If sigma h increases, point A moving towards the right side. That indicates the increase of sigma h. If sigma h decreases, point A moving towards the left side. That indicates the decrease in the sigma h stress. In the active condition, Please give me the response. Is my voice audible to you? Please give me the response. Is my voice audible to you?
Yes, sir.
Thank you, thank you. Unmute the mics, please. Unmute the mics. There is a network problem in the college. Unmute the mics. Now coming to this discussion, we are discussing the active earth pressure in the retaining wall. Active earth pressure in the retaining wall. So first we discuss, please follow this carefully. First we discuss the at rest condition of the backfill. Dear students, please give me the response. Can you see the slide on your cell phones? Is it visible? Can you see the slide on your cell phones? Okay, thank you. Now coming to this discussion, please follow this carefully. Very, very important. Please follow this carefully. First we discuss the at rest condition of the soil element. We prepare the Mohr's stress circle for that at rest condition. This is that Mohr's stress circle AB. The Mohr's stress circle AB indicates the at rest condition of the backfill. In that at rest condition, OA indicates the horizontal stress sigma H, OB indicates the vertical stress sigma V. So point A indicates sigma H in the at rest condition. Point B indicates sigma V in the at rest condition. Then this first Mohr stress circle is the at rest condition. Then coming to the active condition. In the active condition, when the retaining wall is moving away from the backfill. In the active condition, when the retaining wall is moving away from the backfill, sigma V remains constant. So please observe that carefully. In the active condition, sigma V remains constant. But in the active condition, sigma H gradually decreasing. That is active condition, because when the retaining wall is moving away from the backfill is subjected to stretching. Stretching is somewhat relaxation. See, due to that stretching in the backfill, the vertical stress on the element remains constant, but this sigma H gradually decreasing. Now coming to this diagram. In the active condition, sigma V constant, so point B remains same. But in the active condition, sigma H decreasing. Since sigma H is decreasing, point A is moving towards the horizon, because length OA is sigma H, horizontal stress. Since that sigma H is decreasing, length OA also decreases, because sigma H is decreasing. So please follow this carefully. In the diagram, the length OA from horizon up to this point A, length OA is the horizontal stress on the element. In the active condition, this stress sigma H decreasing. So the length OA also decreasing, because sigma H is decreasing. When the length OA decreasing, point A is moving towards the horizon at the beginning stages of active condition. In the beginning stages of the active condition, that is when the retaining wall just starts moving away from the backfill, this sigma H slightly decreases. When the retaining wall just begins to move away from the backfill, that is in the beginning of the active condition, sigma H slightly decreases. Since sigma H slightly decreases by small magnitude, point A, let the point A shifted to A dash, because sigma H slightly decreases. Since sigma H slightly decreases, point A shifted to A dash. So check this point A dash. This point A dash indicates the horizontal stress sigma H in the backfill when the retaining wall just starts moving away from the backfill. That is this condition of point A dash. So the length OA dash, the length OA dash is the stress sigma H on the side element or in the backfill when the retaining wall just starts moving away from the backfill. That is the beginning of the active condition. So please understand this moving of point A from A to A dash. At this point A, the condition is rest condition. Whereas at A dash, the condition is just active condition. The retaining wall starts moving away from the backfill. That is the beginning of the active condition. So the horizontal stress slightly decreases in the backfill. So the point A is moving to A dash. Now the point B remains constant. Take this A dash B as diameter. Prepare the another more stress circle. That is the second more stress circle. So please everyone focus on the diagram. First more stress circle, that is AB diameter, is the at rest condition. Second more stress circle, that is the diameter A dash B, is the more stress circle at the beginning of the active condition. When the retaining wall just starts moving away from the backfill, that is the beginning of the active condition. Sigma H slightly decreases, so the point A shifted to A dash towards the horizon. So this OA dash is the horizontal stress in the beginning of the active condition. By taking this A dash B as a diameter, prepare the second more stress circle. The second more stress circle indicates the stresses in the backfill in the beginning of the active condition. So the second more stress circle is the stress circle. It indicates the stresses in the backfill at the beginning of the active condition. Whereas the first more stress circle indicates the stress in the backfill in the at rest condition. Second more stress circle indicates the stress in the backfill at the beginning of the active condition. Look at this stress circle too. Second more stress circle. The second more stress circle is below the failure envelope. It is below the failure envelope. So in this second condition also, there is no failure in the backfill. That is when the retaining wall just starts moving away from the backfill at the beginning of the active condition, the stress in the backfill is below the failure envelope. So the backfill is not in failure in the beginning of the active condition. Now, if the retaining wall further moving away from the backfill, continuing the active condition. So I discussed the second more stress circle just at the beginning of the active condition. If the retaining wall starts moving further away from the backfill, sigma H in that element again starts decreasing. So when the retaining wall is moving away from the backfill, again the sigma H decreases, starts decreasing. When this sigma H is decreasing, point A dash is shifting to A double dash. So point A dash is at the beginning of the active condition. Point A double dash, when the retaining wall is moving further from the backfill, that is the further active condition. So here, when the retaining wall starts moving away from the backfill, check this diagram, first diagram. Can you see this picture on the cell phones? Please give me the response. Can you see this picture on the cell phones? The first picture. Okay, ma, thank you. Please everyone, coming to this diagram. We started the Rankine's active earth pressure first by considering the backfill in rest condition. Then we discussed when the retaining wall just starts moving away from the backfill. when the retaining wall starts moving away from the backfill, sigma h slightly decreases because of the horizontal stretching. When the retaining wall continue to move away from the backfill, then this sigma h in the backfill reaches the minimum value. So follow that carefully. In the active condition, the retaining wall is moving away from the backfill, so sigma h gradually decreases. When the retaining wall continues that active condition at one stage, the sigma h in the backfill reaches the minimum value. When that sigma h in the backfill reaches the minimum value, the backfill is about to failure. Because this sigma h reaching the minimum value, the backfill is about to failure. That is called verge of failure of the backfill. So at that verge of failure in the active condition, sigma h reaches the minimum value. That is this point A double dash. Point A double dash indicates the minimum value of sigma h acting in the backfill in the active condition. So follow from point A to A dash and from point A dash to A double dash in the diagram. OA is sigma h in the rest condition. OA dash is sigma h about the beginning of the active condition, just at the beginning of the active condition. OA double dash is the sigma h at the minimum condition. So when this retaining wall in the active condition is moving away from the backfill, sigma h in the backfill starts decreasing. At one stage, that sigma h becomes minimum, that is indicated as A double dash. Now by taking this A double dash B as a diameter, A double dash is the minimum value of the sigma h in the backfill. At that minimum value of sigma h, the backfill is in the verge of failure. That is indicated as A double dash in the diagram. So the length OA double dash is the minimum value of the horizontal stress in the backfill in active condition. So now take A double dash B as a diameter, prepare the third Mohr stress circle. Since in this third Mohr stress circle, the backfill is in failure condition. Just now we discussed, in the active condition, sigma h gradually decreases. At one stage, sigma h becomes minimum. At that minimum condition, backfill is under verge of failure. That minimum sigma h is indicated by A double dash. So take this A double dash B as a diameter, prepare the third Mohr stress circle. Since in this A double dash location, at that instant, the backfill is under failure condition in the active state, the stress circle A double dash B is touching the failure envelope. So check that third Mohr stress circle. The third Mohr stress circle at this point touching the failure envelope. When the Mohr stress circle touches the failure envelope, that indicates the failure in the backfill. This touching the failure envelope is indicating the failure in the backfill. So here we have three Mohr stress circles. First Mohr stress circle, rest condition, no failure. Second Mohr stress circle, just at the beginning of the active condition, no failure. Because these two Mohr stress circles are below the failure envelope. But the third Mohr stress circle at a minimum value of sigma h, that is at the full development of the active condition, the backfill is under failure condition at a minimum sigma h. So the third Mohr stress circle touches the failure envelope. When the Mohr stress circle touching the failure envelope, that indicates the verge of failure of the backfill. So in the active condition, at one stage, sigma h becomes minimum, that is indicated as A double dash. Then at A double dash horizontal stress, the Mohr stress circle touching the failure envelope, that indicates the failure of the backfill in the active condition. So check these three Mohr stress circles in the diagram. First more stress circle, rest condition, no failure. Second more stress circle, at the beginning of the active condition, no failure. Third more stress circle, when sigma H reaches the minimum failure condition. This is the active failure condition of the backfill. We know that in this active failure condition, A double dash indicates the minimum horizontal stress in the backfill. This length OA double dash, the length OA double dash is the minimum horizontal stress in the active condition, that is also known as the active lateral pressure acting on the backfill. The length OA double dash, the length OA, please follow this carefully, the length OA is the horizontal stress in the rest condition. The length OA dash is the horizontal stress in the beginning of the active condition, whereas this length OA double dash is the minimum value of sigma H in the active condition, that minimum sigma H, minimum horizontal stress OA double dash is also known as the active horizontal earth pressure in the backfill. So in this active condition, the length OA double dash, that is the minimum horizontal stress in the backfill in active condition, that indicates the active lateral earth pressure in the retaining wall. So follow this more stress circles 1, 2, 3 and also the failure envelopes in the diagram. These are the failure envelopes for the portionless soil according to Mohr's Coulomb equation. So check these three more stress circles. First more stress circle, rest condition, below the failure envelope, no failure in the backfill. The backfill is not subjected to failure. Second more stress circle, at the beginning of the active condition, it is below the failure envelope, so it is also no failure condition. But the third more stress circle, for this third more stress circle, the diameter is A double dash B. OA double dash indicates the minimum value of the horizontal stress. OB indicates the vertical stress sigma V. Then at minimum horizontal stress A double dash, the backfill reaches the failure. So this third more stress circle with the diameter A double dash B reaching the failure envelope. It touches the failure envelope, that indicates the failure condition of this backfill. In the active condition, at a minimum horizontal stress, the backfill behind the retaining wall reaches the failure. Then the minimum sigma H at failure in active condition, that is this OA double dash, is called the active lateral earth pressure or the active horizontal earth pressure acting on the retaining wall, that is indicated as small PA. This small PA is the minimum value of the sigma H in the active condition at the backfill failure. We call this PA as the active horizontal earth pressure acting on the retaining wall. Dear students, if you have any doubts about this Mohr's stress circles, you please discuss with me. If you have any doubts about those Mohr's stress circles 1, 2, 3 in the diagram, you please discuss with me. Any doubts, students, about those Mohr's stress circles 1, 2, 3? Please post your doubts in the chat box. I will give you the answer. This is an important concept in Unit 3, active lateral earth pressure according to Rankine's earth pressure theory. So if you have any doubts about that three more stress circles in front of you, you please discuss with me. Please give me the response. The minimum horizontal earth pressure, sigma H indicated by OA double dash. At A double dash, the Mohr's stress circle touches the failure envelope. That indicates the failure condition in the backfill. At the time of failure of backfill in the active condition, the stress sigma h becomes minimum. That minimum sigma h in the active condition, that is OA double dash, is called the active horizontal pressure in the backfill or acting on the retaining wall. So in the diagram, OA double dash, the length OA double dash indicates the active horizontal earth pressure acting in the retaining wall, and the Morse stress circle A double dash B, that is the third Morse stress circle, is the Morse stress circle for the active condition. It is the Morse stress circle for the active condition A double dash B. So this is the lateral earth pressure theory, Rankine's earth pressure theory for the active condition. When this Morse stress circle touches the failure envelope, the horizontal earth pressure becomes minimum, that is OA double dash, indicated as PA, active lateral earth pressure. At that minimum sigma h situation, the backfill behind the retaining wall subjected to failure. Now coming to that derivation of PA, the active lateral earth pressure, derivation of PA. Now coming to this diagram, this is the third Morse stress circle. Just now we discussed the third Morse stress circle for the failure condition of backfill in active condition. The third Morse stress circle, point B indicates the vertical stress. In the previous diagram, A double dash indicates the active earth pressure, but in the diagram, in this diagram, I consider A double dash as E. Just one modification. This circle is same as the previous circle. Just now we discuss the third Morse stress circle in the active condition. In that previous diagram, we consider this as A double dash. But for calculation purpose, I consider that A double dash is E. So this length OE is the minimum horizontal earth pressure in the rest condition, that is called the active horizontal earth pressure PA. So OE indicates the PA, active horizontal earth pressure in the backfill. So this diagram is same as the previous diagram. I omitted first Morse stress circle, I omitted second Morse stress circle, I consider only the third Morse stress circle. We know that this third Morse stress circle touching the failure envelope, because the backfill is in failure condition. In the active situation, the third Morse stress circle touches the failure envelope. Let this third Morse stress circle touching the failure envelope at point D. This is the point where the third Morse stress circle in the active condition, when the backfill is about to failure, is touching the failure envelope at point D. I consider A double dash as E in the diagram. One modification. I consider the point A double dash as E. So this length OE, the length OE is the minimum horizontal earth pressure in the active condition, that is called the active horizontal earth pressure PA. By using this diagram, we can prepare the equation for this active horizontal earth pressure PA. Check this diagram, follow this diagram. In this diagram, with horizontal or with normal stress axis, the failure envelope is making the angle phi dash. With horizontal or the normal stress axis, the failure envelope is making the angle phi dash. Phi dash is called the angle of shearing resistance of soil. C is the center of the third Morse stress circle. Point C is the center. Point B is the vertical stress. Point E is the minimum horizontal stress, that is called the active horizontal pressure PA. C is the center of this line EB. EB is the diameter of Morse stress circle. C is the center. If I join the center C and point D, if I join these two points by straight line with this horizontal, that is makes an angle of 90 degrees plus phi dash. So follow this angle carefully. Here this angle is phi dash, and this is the diameter, this is the radius CD. The radius CD with tangent, this failure angle means tangent to the circle at D. With tangent, this radius CD, here this makes an angle 90 degrees. The total angle is 90 degrees. Then this third angle point, see here the third angle is 90 minus phi, because one angle is phi dash, second angle is 90 degrees. So the sum of these two angles is 90 plus phi dash. So this third angle, here this third angle is 90 minus phi dash. Then this outside angle, so this is semicircle angle, the total of semicircle is 180 degrees, and here this small angle is 90 minus phi dash, so the remaining angle is 90 plus phi dash. So this line CD with horizontal or the normal stress axis making the angle of 90 plus phi dash, then join point E and point D, join these two points E and D. According to properties of triangles, if the outside angle is 90 plus phi dash, then this inside angle at point E is half of this outside angle. So 90 plus phi dash by 2, it is 45 degrees plus phi dash. This is from the properties of the circles. Outside angle is 90 plus phi dash at point C. So at point E, the inside angle, we are joining point C, point D, point E and point D also. At point C, outside angle is 90 plus phi dash. So at point E, inside angle is 45 degrees plus phi dash, half of this angle. So follow this diagram. By using this diagram, we are going to prepare the equation for the active origin earth pressure, PA. The length OE indicates the PA, horizontal active earth pressure. The length OB indicates the vertical stress. C is the midpoint of this line EB. EB is the diameter of the more stress circle at the failure of backfill in active condition. So join point C and point D. The angle is 90 degrees plus phi dash. Point E, point D, the angle is half of this angle, 45 degrees plus phi dash. Now by using this diagram, that is the more stress circle in the active failure condition. The third more stress circle is at the active failure condition of the backfill. By using this third more stress circle, we are going to prepare the equation for this active horizontal earth pressure, PA. So please follow this diagram. The length OE is the earth pressure, PA. I can write this length OE. The length OE is equal to the length OC minus the length CE. I can write this length OE is equal to the length OC minus the length CE. So OE is equal to OC minus CE. Take this triangle OCD. Take the triangle OCD. In that triangle OCD, here the angle is phi dash. Phi dash. So take in this triangle OCD, follow the steps carefully. So we know that in the above diagram, the active horizontal earth pressure is given by PA, that is equal to OE. The length OE is the active horizontal earth pressure, PA. The length OE is equal to OC minus CE. The length OC is the length OE is OC minus CE. Check the diagram. CE is the diameter radius of circle. The length CE is radius of circle. The length CD is also radius of circle. So in the diagram, the length CE is equal to length CD. So you can write this OE. The length OE is equal to the length, follow this carefully, the length OE is equal to the length OC minus the length CE. but the length CE is equal to length CD. So you can write this length CE as CD. So the length OE is equal to length OE is equal to length OC minus length CD, because CE is equal to CD. Take this right angle triangle OCD. From this right angle triangle, sine phi dash is equal to sine phi dash is equal to opposite side is CD, hypotenuse is OC. So sine phi dash is equal to CD divided by OC. So check the calculation carefully. So here, from the previous diagram, the length OE, it is equal to PA, active original pressure, that is equal to OC minus CE. But CE is radius, that is also equal to CD. So we can write this length OE is equal to OC minus CD. Then we consider the right angle triangle OCD. In the right angle triangle, sin phi is equal to CD divided by OC. So the length CD is equal to OC sin phi. The length CD, it is also equal to CE, is equal to OC sin phi. Substitute this in this equation. So the PA, active lateral earth pressure, PA is equal to OC minus OC sin phi. This OC sin phi is equal to CD, that is equal to CE. Then simplify this right hand side. PA is equal to OC into 1 minus sin phi. So please understand that calculation of PA from this diagram. So we consider the third Mohr stress circle. This is at the failure condition of the active movement of retaining wall. The third Mohr stress circle is the failure condition of the backfill when the retaining wall is in active condition, moving away from the backfill. In this diagram, the length OE indicates the minimum original earth pressure on the retaining wall, that is called the active original earth pressure on the retaining wall PA. So we are going to find out the equation of this PA by using this diagram. So this length OE is equal to PA. The length OE is equal to length OC minus length CE. CE is the diameter of the circle, that is equal to the CE is the radius of the circle, that is equal to radius CD. Both are same. The radius CE and the radius CD both are same. So take this right angle triangle OCD. In this right angle triangle OCD, sin phi dash is equal to opposite side CD divided by hypotenuse OC. So this CD is equal to OC into sin phi dash. But CD is equal to CE. So CD is equal to CE is equal to OC sin phi dash. Substitute this in this equation, you will get the equation of PA, active original earth pressure. PA is equal to OC minus CE, that is equal to OC sin phi, that is equal to OC into 1 minus sin phi. Take it as equation 1. Then coming to that diagram, in the diagram, OB is equal to the vertical stress sigma V. The length OB is the vertical stress sigma V. You can write this length OB. The length OB is equal to the length OC plus the length BC. So follow this carefully. The length OB is equal to sigma V. The length OB is equal to the length OC plus the length BC. The length BC is the radius of the circle. The length BC is the radius. That length BC is equal to the length CD. CD is also radius. CB is also radius. So the length BC is equal to length CD. Just now we calculated the length CD is equal to OC into sin phi. So coming to the calculation of the vertical stress sigma V. In the diagram, vertical stress is OB. OB is equal to OC plus CB. The vertical stress is sigma V is equal to OB. OB is equal to OC plus CB. CB is the radius of the circle. Since CB is the radius, CB is equal to CD. Just now we calculated this CD. CD is equal to OC sin phi. So substitute it here. The vertical stress sigma V is equal to vertical stress sigma V is equal to OC plus OC into sin phi. Take OC common in the right side. So sigma v is equal to OC into 1 plus sin phi. So by using that previous diagram, by using this diagram, we calculate the equation of PA, we calculate the equation of sigma V, this diagram. We know that PA is equal to OC into 1 minus sin phi, sigma V is equal to OC into 1 plus sin phi. PA is the active original length pressure and OC is the sigma V is the vertical stress in the backfill. Now find out this ratio PA divided by sigma V from equation 1 to equation 2. Using equation 1, equation 2, find out the ratio PA by sigma V. PA by sigma V is equal to 1 minus OC will cancel on the right side, OC will cancel. So you will get on the right side 1 minus sin phi by 1 plus sin phi. So by using the equation 1, equation 2, we calculate this ratio PA by sigma V. PA is the active original length pressure in the backfill and sigma V is the vertical stress. PA by sigma V is equal to OC into 1 minus sin phi by OC into 1 plus sin phi. OC will cancel. So it is 1 minus sin phi by 1 plus sin phi, equation 3. Check this left hand side. PA is the horizontal stress in the active condition. Sigma V is the vertical stress. Already I discussed with you, I informed you in geotechnical engineering, the ratio between the horizontal stress to vertical stress. Please remember this always. The ratio between the horizontal stress in the soil to vertical stress in the soil is called the coefficient of earth pressure. Horizontal stress sigma h divided by sigma v. Sigma h by sigma v is called the coefficient of earth pressure. We discuss this in the rest condition. In the rest condition, we discuss sigma h by sigma v as k naught. That is the coefficient of earth pressure in the rest condition, k naught. But in this discussion, we are in active condition. So in that equation 3, left hand side, PA is the active original earth pressure, sigma v is the vertical stress. That ratio in the equation 3, left hand side, PA by sigma h, the ratio between the active original earth pressure to vertical stress sigma v is called the coefficient of active earth pressure Ka. Coefficient of active earth pressure Ka. So in that equation 3, the left hand side Pa divided by sigma v. So in this equation 3, the ratio Pa is the active original earth pressure, sigma v is the vertical stress. The ratio between the horizontal stress to vertical stress is called the coefficient of earth pressure. Since it is in the active condition, we indicate that as Ka. Ka is called the coefficient of active earth pressure, that is equal to Pa by sigma v, that is equal to 1 minus sin phi by 1 plus sin phi. So in the active condition of retaining wall, when the retaining wall is in active condition, the backfill applies the active lateral earth pressure on the retaining wall. Pa is that active lateral earth pressure acting on the retaining wall from the backfill. Then in the active condition, the ratio between the active earth pressure Pa to vertical stress is called the coefficient of active earth pressure Ka. According to equation 3, Ka is equal to Pa by sigma v, that is equal to 1 minus sin phi by 1 plus sin phi. In the rest condition, we have one coefficient, that is k naught, the coefficient of at rest earth pressure. In the active condition, we have another coefficient Ka, the coefficient of active earth pressure. Ka is equal to Pa by sigma v, that is equal to 1 minus sin phi by 1 plus sin phi. Phi is the angle of shearing resistance of soil. So in the active original earth pressure, this constant Ka is coming to the picture in the Rankine earth pressure theory. Ka is equal to Pa by sigma v, that is equal to 1 minus sin phi by 1 plus sin phi. So this is that coefficient of active earth pressure, Ka, 1 minus sin phi by 1 plus sin phi, that is also equal to, according to trigonometry, that is also equal to tan square 45 degrees minus pi by 2. This is according to trigonometry. Then from this equation 4, Pa is equal to Ka into sigma v. Pa is the active ordinary earth pressure. Pa is equal to Ka into sigma v. Sigma v is the vertical stress. So according to Rankine's active earth pressure theory, the equation to determine the active ordinary earth pressure acting on the retaining wall is given by equation 5. Pa is equal to Ka into sigma v. This is according to the Rankine's active earth pressure theory. In this equation, sigma v is the vertical stress in the backfill, Pa is the active ordinary stress in the backfill, Ka is the coefficient of active earth pressure, that is equal to 1 minus sin phi by 1 plus sin phi. Now, when the backfill is under moist condition, that is partially saturated, we know that sigma v is equal to gamma z, gamma into z, sigma v. Gamma is the bulk unit weight, z is the depth from the backfill. So in the moist condition, when the backfill is under moist condition, gamma is the bulk unit weight of soil. So sigma v is equal to gamma into z. In that condition, this active ordinary earth pressure Pa is equal to Ka into gamma into z. So that is this condition. So in the active condition also, at a depth z from the backfill, vertical stress is equal to gamma into z. This is for the moist condition of backfill. Since sigma v is equal to gamma z, at a depth z from the top of the backfill, the active ordinary earth pressure Pa is equal to Ka into gamma into z. This is the equation of active ordinary earth pressure according to Rankine's theory, Rankine's earth pressure theory. At the top of the backfill, z is equal to 0. At the bottom of the retaining wall, z is equal to h. So by using this equation 6, we can prepare the active earth pressure distribution diagram on the backside of the retaining wall. So in the active condition, the retaining wall is moving away from the backfill. So the backfill applies the horizontal active earth pressure on the retaining wall. According to Rankine's theory, Pa is equal to Ka into gamma into z. At top of the backfill, z is equal to 0, so Pa is 0. At the bottom of the retaining wall, z is equal to h. So at the bottom of the retaining wall, the active ordinary earth pressure is Ka into gamma into z. At a depth z from the top of the retaining wall, the active earth pressure is Ka into gamma into z. So the active earth pressure depending on this z only, not z square or z cube. Since it depending on only z, the distribution is a linear distribution. So at the top of the backfill, z is 0. So Pa is 0. At the bottom of the retaining wall, z is h. So Pa is Ka into gamma h. So the distribution is a linear distribution from top to the bottom. This is called the active earth pressure distribution diagram on the retaining wall. We call this distribution diagram as the active earth pressure distribution diagram on the retaining wall. At the top of the backfill, earth pressure is 0. Active earth pressure is 0. At the bottom of the retaining wall, the active earth pressure is Ka into gamma into h. The area of this distribution diagram is the total active earth pressure force acting on the retaining wall, that is Pa. Pa is the total active earth pressure force acting on the retaining wall, that is equal to area of this distribution diagram. Area of this distribution diagram is half into height of the triangle h. Base of the triangle is Ka into gamma into h. So the area of this diagram is half Ka gamma into h square, that is this force Pa. Pa is called the active earth pressure force acting on the retaining wall. while designing this retaining wall for the active condition, we must consider this earth pressure force acting on the retaining wall. Since it is a triangular distribution, from this base of the triangle, PA acts at a height of h by 3. So this is the active earth pressure for the dry condition of this backfill. That backfill is under partially saturated condition. For the dry condition of backfill, according to Rankine's earth pressure theory. Dear students, if you have any doubts up to this discussion on the active earth pressure, you please interact with me. According to Rankine's earth pressure theory, we prepare the equation for the active earth pressure PA acting on the retaining wall. If anybody is having doubt up to this distribution diagram behind the retaining wall in the active condition, you please discuss with me. Any doubt, students, in this active earth pressure on the retaining wall? So in the today's class, we discussed Rankine's earth pressure assumptions. We discuss the Rankine's active earth pressure theory, first by assuming the rest condition. We prepare the first Mohr stress circle. Then when the retaining wall just moving away from the backfill, that is at the beginning of the active condition, we discuss the second Mohr stress circle, A dash B. Then when the retaining wall continues in the active condition, sigma H becomes minimum. At that stage, the backfill is under failure condition. That sigma H at the minimum condition is called the active earth pressure acting on the retaining wall, that is OA double dash. Then we consider the third Mohr stress circle touching the failure envelope at the failure condition of the backfill. In the second diagram, A double dash is taken as E. So by considering the third Mohr stress circle EB in the last diagram, we prepare the equation of PA OC into 1 minus sin phi. We prepare the equation of sigma V OC into 1 plus sin phi. So PA by sigma V is equal to 1 minus sin phi by 1 plus sin phi. PA by sigma V is called the coefficient of active earth pressure KA. So PA is equal to KA into sigma V. In the moist condition, sigma V is equal to gamma H. So PA is equal to KA into gamma H. PA is equal to KA into gamma Z. At the top of the backfill, that is equal to zero. At the bottom of the retaining wall, that is equal to H. So we got the distribution of active earth pressure for the retaining wall like this. This is the distribution of the active earth pressure. The area of this distribution diagram is the active earth pressure force PA acting on the retaining wall of KA gamma into H square. So this is the active earth pressure acting on the retaining wall according to Rankine's earth pressure theory when this backfill is under partially saturated condition. Okay, definitely I will send the PDF material of this earth pressures, that is unit 3. First of all, try to understand the rest condition and the active condition of the retaining wall. Definitely I will send the material to you. I will pass on this material, total material. I am preparing that material. So if anybody is having doubt, you please discuss with me.